Sazi, thank you so much for your time this morning. 9 distinctions, and this is just in your prelims. From what we understand, if school is still the way it used to be in 1910 when I was there, surely that was the most difficult part, the prelims, which means that we're expecting not only just 9 out of 9, we're expecting 10 out of 9 for you ahead of these final exams. How are you feeling, Sazi?
Oh, the pressure's on. No, I'm great. Thanks so much for having me. I'm delighted to be here this morning. Yeah, it was a crazy year, but for it to culminate with this decision for me, it makes it all worth it. So yeah, I've got so much joy and excitement right now.
Yeah. I mean, have you always wanted to go to Harvard? How did the decision to actually go to Harvard actually come about?
Yeah, I think it's very much been a conversation and an idea that's floated around at home that I would apply and hopefully get into Harvard, certainly from my parents' point of view. And engaging in the application process, I had to think very rationally about which application I prioritized. And Harvard was the school. I made many considerations and evaluations about where I wanted to see myself, and all of them pointed to Harvard. So, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it certainly was a very difficult year for all matriculants, right? Anybody that is in school has undergone, the past 2 years has been particularly hard, given the fact that we're just in the midst of a COVID-19 pandemic. How has your experience been as a young person who has to be focused, who has to remain vigilant, but has to still navigate the fact that we're in the midst of a pandemic?
Yeah, absolutely. That's definitely an appropriate reflection, especially for me in student leadership. Just seeing the impact on mental health has been very crazy. So, I mean, for me, both engaging with other people, but also trying to take care of myself, it's been such a whirlwind journey, and nothing could have prepared us for it. But I mean, we're here and we're grateful to be here. But yeah, I mean, definitely a huge experience that I'm not sure I can even put into words.
Yeah. I mean, I want to labor on this point because I think a lot of young people, as you've mentioned, they don't speak enough about mental health or acknowledge some of the weaknesses and some of the challenges that they're going through. Within your peers, within St. John's College as well, did those conversations around how do we keep ourselves mentally okay come up, and how do you guys navigate that as a school?
Yeah, I mean, me personally, I'm very lucky to be in a very conscious, aware, and empathetic friendship group. So, I mean, definitely around the people I surrounded myself with, we made sure that we were coping and that we were okay. On a broader level, at St. John's, we're very lucky to have good, trained, educated, and very well-informed mental health professionals working in our psychology department, and we recently had a new one come in. So, I mean, support both from the psychological department, but also just from teachers in general, we very much felt held by the school, and that's probably not a sweeping statement. I know that there are people who would have very much struggled, but yeah, definitely a huge year, but I trust that people would have had a network or a resource or a place to go to, and I think I hope that for all students that would have been true, however the case.
Yeah. Sazi, after Harvard, then what? I mean, once you got into Harvard, many would say the world is literally your oyster and the sky is literally the beginning. So what happens afterwards?
Yeah, I mean, I hope 4 years from now me doesn't come back and look at this and laugh at myself, but I definitely do want to study further and hopefully get a qualification beyond an undergraduate degree. I'm super interested in that kind of research element. Outside of that, I mean, a lot of the application process is you linking things that you've done in your matric year or like your previous years to your long-term plans. And I think that's true for me. So I did a very enriching shadowing experience at the WITS Southern Center of Inequality Studies under an economist called Arawo Ewunyu. And that was really interesting for me. So, I mean, hopefully, if I do get a degree in economics or social studies, I can take that into very practical policy work or development work around economics. But I also got to work, very fortunately, with the Mail and Guardian. And so I'm very interested in thought leadership, and hopefully becoming a really reliable voice and opinion in South African discourse and even global discourse. So, I mean, I don't think my plans are very set in place. I'm so excited to just explore and see how Harvard shapes me. But yeah, I mean, that's the idea right now, but I'm so happy to see it evolve, hopefully.
Listen, as you're speaking right now, I keep looking at my my co-anchor here, Ropio, and going, this guy cannot be 18 years old. There is no way you're that brilliant and you're 18 years old. So we're very, very, very proud of you. But Sazi, you know, just looking at, you know, you're speaking here about how even with the qualifications, you're looking at research and going beyond that. But in order for you to even get into Harvard, you also got in through a needs-based financial aid program. I'm just thinking of other young people, brilliant young South Africans who, you know, may come from disadvantaged backgrounds, who also have got aspirations of getting into Harvard one day. Now that you've gone through this journey and now you've been qualified, how would you advise them? What would you say to them if they have got similar aspirations of going into an Ivy League, you know, institution, even overseas?
Yeah, I mean, I said this to the Sunday Times. I think the biggest thing that I can say is just that it's possible. I think for many people, either financial aid and affordability is a deterrent, or just the idea, this like mysticism of the Ivy League puts them off even the idea of applying. If there's one thing I can do, and I hope to do, is to just demystify all that and say that this is a very real thing. All you can do, all that I did, was to present myself to them and say, this is who I am, this is what I've done. And at the end of the day, it's about matching you as a candidate and as a person to an institution that fits you. And I think I have found a fit at Harvard, and I have no doubt that there's a school for everybody there. So, I mean, especially people from disadvantaged backgrounds, when Harvard says that they meet your full financial need, they mean it genuinely, and I've experienced that firsthand. So affordability shouldn't deter you, and neither should the idea of being some exceptional person who is gifted in all these senses. I think so long as you're authentic and you dedicate yourself to the things that you do, you will find absolutely the correct school for you.
I love it. All the best, Sazi. We look forward to having a conversation with you once you've graduated from Harvard and pursuing other, of course, endeavors there. But congratulations and very, very well done. St. John's College head boy there, Sazi Bong.